Alrighty, another tear down. This time, completely out of left field. A Mac G5. This one is beyond repair. Basically, it's suffered a... Well, I'll be honest with you, I think the logic board in it's absolutely fucked. You put power to it and it just... The fans go to full throttle. There's no power on chime. Nothing. So, to someone like myself, I would probably suggest that the logic board's had it, or something on the logic board has had it. But not being an Apple person, who knows? Anyhow, to get into these, do that, and up she comes. A bit of random plastic. Straight to the side. Now then, not much really to them, basically. I've already used the DVD drive and the hard drive from something else, but we're going to pull it apart. And we're going to see what makes an Apple tick. Now, I know I have been tempted a few times in turning it into like a Hackintosh. I don't know. Don't know if I'll ever get to do that, but we'll come to that at some stage. Alright, now, unlike your average PC or a Sun system, it's all got this divider shit in it. Anyhow, alright. So, next thing to get out is the fans. Pretty easy to get them out. Set the plug out. As I said, this is a G5, so it's a PAL PC. Alrighty, so the next thing I think we've got to do is get our screwdriver. We'll get this out. We'll get this fan out of here too. You'll see there it's a little speaker. Now, as I said, the problem with this is that the something on the logic board's given out, and I don't know what. It could be any number of things that's caused it. I haven't spent a lot of time with Apple computers per se, mainly because I guess when I got into computers heavily, it was Windows, Windows, and Windows. Basically, was what I was exposed to. And now working, helping my mate out at his, helping my mate out at his TV station. Mac plays a slightly bigger role from a video point of view, I guess. Now, how do we get this out, do you reckon? Can't be much holding it in. Oh, yes, there is still a fair bit here. So, now, probably all the purists out there are going to have 60 fits with me pulling this apart. And why don't I fix it? Well, I've got a G5. I've got a dual processor G5. This is only a single processor. I've got a dual processor inside, so realistically, I don't actually need it. Let's get these screws out of here. MacOS, I know MacOS is Unix based, it's, you know, Darwin kernel and all this type of stuff, but, you know, I just find when they break, they tend to break, and they break hard. And once they're broken, they're very hard to fix again if you don't know what the hell you're doing. And that's what's happened with me. I don't know what I'm doing with them half the bloody time. And so I just tend to pull them apart. All right, let's get the fan out. So there's the PCI fan, cooling fan, and the little squeaker. not really a speaker, even though it looks like a speaker, it's just a squeaker. As I said, something on here is fucked, but I've got no idea what. So, I'll get the rest of these screws out. We can get in there. Because, you know, get all the screws out at least. One thing I like about this screwdriver is the tip's magnetic. So it's great when you've got to reach down into places like this where the screws are very hard to get a hold of. Got it. It still doesn't want to come out. I wonder what, oh, hello, there's a screwed onto the motherboard. Now, I know I call most circuit boards motherboards. Apple doesn't. They call this a logic board. But let's kiss it, as in keep it simple, stupid. The Wi-Fi connection. Yes. Okay. Need to break that off. Get rid of that. Alright, that can go into the recycle bin. Righto. Actually, when you think about it, there's a fair bit of room now in here without all that other crap. So, what's next? Well, we'll get the button battery out of it. There we go. We'll take the IDE lead out. A little short IDE lead for the optical drive. I never, ever, ever throw out SATA leads, IDE leads, SCSI leads, etc. Because you never know when you're going to come across a unit that you need to replace the lead on. Whether it be old, whether it be new, whatever. I never, ever throw out leads. Same here. I'll salvage the SATA leads. So, the next thing to do, I think, will be to disconnect everything. I can work out how to do it. I know at the moment all the purists watching this video are like, no, don't, you're killing it. Well, to be brutally honest, it's not worth repairing it, in actual fact. Okay, so we've got to get that one off. Get the pliers to it, I think will be the best idea. And break that clip right out if I can. Again, it might just be easier to take the heatsink off. Alright, so what we might do is try and see how the heatsink comes off, shall we? Alright, actually, that's not going to work. We might as well try and get the that power plug off first, mightn't we? Let me get that power plug off first, and then we'll try and get the board out. Hang on. Alright, well, after a few choice words, I got this plug off. I don't know what this plug's for. Possibly a CPU pair, I'd say. There's our Broadcom Ethernet down there. And if we turn the unit around, you can have a look at the details on the board. So there they are there. Model 820-1608-A 2004. Right, so what we'll do now, I think, is we'll get the SATA leads out and then we'll pull the whole logic board out. I think that's probably going to be the easiest way of doing it. So I guess the other thing that gives me the shits about Apple computers, and I know the purists will hate this, it's very hard to get to anything when you've got fat fingers like mine. I'll just rip that right off. Okay, so there's the SATA leads out of the road. So I'm going to pull them out. The next thing to do would be to remove this supply plug. I don't know what that's for. That goes up to that little thing up there. I wonder what that's for. I don't even see it there really well. This little thing here. I don't know what that thing's for. Someone will probably tell me. Alright, so now what we'll do is we'll get all these screws out. See if we can get in there with a power drive, shall we? Probably not. There we go. Make sure we're unwinding and not winding up. Oh, maybe not. No, I'm going to have to do it the old way. Alright. So, I'll pull this apart because it'll be interesting to see, I guess from my own curiosity too, what makes an Apple computer tick. I'll probably have a lot of people killing me about now, you've destroyed a perfectly good computer. Well, it was perfectly good when it worked, but once it died, it's a different story really, isn't it? I've always found it interesting when you're talking to people who are Apple nuts about their Apple computers, and they often just say, well, it does everything. You know, it just always works. Well, I suppose if you've bought an Apple computer, you can afford to repair one, really, isn't it? And we need to get these big beasties out here. So we've got a screw there. Another one just there. And I think it should just fall out. In theory. Isn't it funny? Things always work in theory. You know the old adage? In theory, everything works. It's not always the case in reality, though, is it? Alright. I will admit one thing, people. When it comes to graphic design and video editing, a Mac will outperform a PC. I will give them that. A Mac will always outperform a PC. Another bloody plug here that's stopping me getting this out. Hang on. Oh, a bit of brute force. Alright, so it should pop up. We've got a screw on, we've got another plug here. Okay, so we're still going to get this plug off, which I forgot about. Hang on. Okay, one empty board. Got Sardaline power. Looks like an ATX plug, doesn't it, without the extender? Well, maybe it's got the extender in it. Don't know what this is for. No idea. PSU's down in there. There's the IEC in there. All right. So I guess now what we do is have a look at the motherboard. Just lifted the case up and they're very light. Look, all the weight's in this this thing. Okay, so back side of the motherboard, PCIX. I think this is PCIe for memory. This is graphics. I know that this is your main graphics output. So if you haven't got a card there, you haven't got any graphics. PCIX, so this is not a PCIe model, it's PCIX. Four possible DIMMs. I think it could only handle up to 4 gig, maybe more. A power in, or a motherboard power. That's another power slot, but I don't know what that does. No idea. And then all our onboard I.O. So, how do we get to the CPU? Allen keys. All right. That's going to be too big. I guess I better find my Allen keys. Hang on. All right. So instead of doing what I did with the V880 and using a set of Allen keys, use the power drive. This will save a bit of time. Saves a lot of time, actually, doesn't it? Yeah, spring-loaded screws for tension, making sure that everything's held down at the right tension. I've still got to get these out too, but at the moment, I'm just taking the heat sink out. So that should now mean that I can get the... I can't. No, the heatsink still won't come off. Alright, so we've got to get another Allen key to get these ones out. Alright, next Allen key. Should fit. Well, maybe not. Wrong size. Well, this could be interesting. Alright, hang on. Alright, yet again today my brain has failed me. They're not, they're bloody long Allen keys, aren't they? All right. Let's do this again, shall we? There we go. Nothing like therapeutic destruction of IT equipment, eh? Now, I'm going to be honest with you, I don't actually know what a Power Mac or a G5 processor looks like, so it'll be news to me as well. Right. So now it should just come off. Alright, so there's the heat sink. What the f- that's the processor? You're kidding me. That's stinking tiny compared to a Intel or Spark processor. And Spark's RISC, so is this. That's really, really small. What? Okay. Someone needs to explain to me something. And remembering that I'm not good with Apple, you've got this giant fucking heat sink. I mean, the thing's huge. Right? Two big heat pipes. And this little tiny copper mounting block onto that. What the fuck? Okay, so, it's PowerPC, obviously. I've got no idea how fast it is. It's, looks like it's mounted to the board. Must be. Well, I'm going to be honest with you people. Yeah, I don't know what to say. I'm quite surprised, actually, that I'll be honest with you here, I've got no idea about these systems, so we're gonna, there's a bit of a learning curve for me. I mean, you look at a Spark processor or an Intel processor and it's about that big. That's the chip. Ugh. Well, that was not expected. I was expecting a chip under here. And I got what looks like a button. All right. So, let's have a look at what's under this thing then. So, oh, we've got a bit more information under here. I'll have a look at that. Gets that heat sink off. Let me go find the rag. All right, found the rag. Let's have a look at what's under this chip under here then, shall we? Without doing too much damage. It is, it's an IBM chip. I've got no idea. I've got no idea what that is. That might be the, yeah, I don't know what that's for, people. Maybe someone can actually explain to me this, but that's the CPU, which to me looks about the size of an Intel SATA RAID chip, and this IBM chip, which is, well, if you mount the board as it would be in the tower, I don't know, would you call that the West Bridge? I don't know. I don't understand Macs well enough. So, there is a Mac G5 logic board. See, that's got, looks like it's got Thunderbolt on it too, as well as FireWire. And built-in modem. See if we can find the modem chip. There's the modem chip. So that's the modem, I'd say, or is that the NIC? So I've got a Broadcom chip there. Made for Apple. And we've got another Broadcom chip there. Again, made for Apple. I'm bewildered by this. That's really got me fucked. Either Apple's CPUs have a habit of getting super hot that they need a massive copper heat piped heat sink, and they need that much cooling, or Apple wants you to think the processors are massive and that's why they need the big heat sink. That's unbelievable. I'll admit, I don't know a lot about Apple, but shit, that's the CPU. Holy shit. All right, well, there's the teardown of a Mac G5. See, I thought the CPU would have been even, you know, maybe out to here even, but that's really thrown me, people. All right, well, there's a Mac G5 teardown. Might keep the case. I may keep the case. Obviously, I'll have to check it electrically to make sure that the logic board being fucked hasn't been caused by a PSU, but I doubt it, because the hard drives are spinning up, everything spins up, so who knows. Anyway, thanks for watching. Probably won't get another destruction video up again till maybe Saturday or Sunday, but don't worry, I've got plenty of teardowns to come. Thanks very much for watching.